What's up, everyone? Alex here. Even though I've been playing video games for a better part of 40 years, it never ceases to amaze me what kind of experiences designers have been able to come up with. Take Nintendo's Animal Crossing New Horizons, for example, which proved that experiences focused on more relaxed gameplay have widespread appeal, quickly making it one of the company's best-selling games of all time. Perhaps a good follow-up question to ask then is if there's a way to expand on this concept. I believe that Spry Fox's Cozy Grove is the answer to this question, a game that not only respects your time, but also delivers a heartwarming experience that you'll want to visit time and time again. This review was made possible by viewers, like you, so please leave a like, comment, then subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this video. Cozy Grove is a life sim that is set on an island filled with spirited residents, developed by the folks at Spry Fox and published by the Quantum Astrophysicists Guild, who provided this PS4 review code. You play the role of a young spirit scout, who's tasked with helping the inhabitants of the island of Cozy Grove. The thing is that its inhabitants have passed on from this mortal plane, and it's up to you to help them find peace. You'll achieve this by helping them with their various day-to-day tasks, slowly restoring vibrance and color to the island, while beckoning other spirits to join in the reverie. While this concept might sound grim, after all, anything to do with death is often tied to heavy emotional stories about loss, Cozy Grove tackles the afterlife in a lighthearted manner that is nothing short of inviting. This is reinforced thanks in part to the long-established art style that Spry Fox has been perfecting for over a decade now, spanning as far back as their very first game, the addictive puzzler, Triple Town. The spirits inhabiting Cozy Grove are mostly comprised of smooth block-shaped creatures, mostly bears, whose occupations are a reflection of their former life. Each of your new spirit pals has their own unique story to tell, and it's up to you to discover these in your own time. Speaking of, there have been games released recently that might look relaxed and chill, but actually offer the opposite experience. Games such as Harvest Moon, Story of Seasons, and Rune Factory, for example, offer rich gameplay experiences that are far deeper than any JRPG ever released, which often conflicts with the idea of a relaxing time in many ways. And then there's games like Animal Crossing New Horizons, which sometimes makes players feel as though it's important to check in on their island on a near daily basis, just so they don't miss out on anything good. While I absolutely loved all the games I've mentioned, it's noteworthy to say that Cozy Grove takes an entirely different approach than any of the aforementioned series. While the game does take your local time into account to an extent, time in Cozy Grove will never move forward unless you visit the island, ensuring that you don't miss a thing. Each time you visit, you will be shown what day it is on the island, further reinforcing the idea that Cozy Grove will be there waiting for you, regardless of how busy you've gotten in your life. Your visits will entail you to check in on your spirit pals, with some either asking you to find certain items of value or have you make certain items. Your rewards will vary depending on your spirit pal's appearance, but if you manage to help them while they're in their ghostly form, they'll not only restore color to the land surrounding them, but they'll also reward you with spirit wood. These spirit woods serve as your campfire, flamey's, snack, and the more spirit wood flamey eats, the brighter its light will become, beckoning more spirits to move into Cozy Grove. What's even more fascinating about Cozy Grove is that this isn't a game that you can beat traditionally by spending long hours at a time. The game is designed to only trickle a few story quests a day, which Spry Fox estimates is approximately 30 to 45 minutes of gameplay per visit. This range is partially dependent on how keen you are in remembering your island's ever-changing landmarks and features, which will help you search for some of the lost items they want you to find. If you have the coin, however, you can always go to Charlotte Pine, give her 100 coins, and she'll show you the location of one of the items you're looking for. Later quests will have you farming for items that might only show up a few times per day, which prolongs their completion. That said, other, shorter quests become available as you're working through these longer-term quests. In order to mitigate the length of some of these quests, you'll have to engage with various systems outside of appeasing your spirit pals, which is gameplay not counted towards Spry Fox's daily estimations. To give you an example, one story quest will have you gather a dozen eggs so that the local chef can make one boiled egg. And before you say anything, yes, this silliness is part of the chef's story. while the shopkeeper only sells one egg a day. You can hasten the acquisition of eggs by buying a bird from him, setting them down at your camp, and working on building your bond with them. This can be done by surrounding them with objects they love, as well as feeding them what they want once a day. Once they've matured, you'll earn an egg each time you feed them. This might sound more trouble than it's worth, but building this relationship isn't as time-consuming as you might think, which is yet another testament to the careful choices Spryfox had to make to offer depth of gameplay while keeping things approachable. Part of why this works is because of how Cozy Grove always waits for you to come back and visit. And with almost every return, you're ever so gingerly introduced to new features that you can explore and experiment with. Much of your time beyond Spryfox estimations can be spent playing around with these features, though you'll probably notice that the island's resources will run out eventually, which is yet another way for Cozy Grove to coax you to stop playing. The idea of a game having features to limit your gameplay time will definitely sound strange to a lot of people. After all, one of the many joys of being an adult is to be able to do things however long you want. For me personally, I love that Cozy Grove does this for me. It allows me to engage with the game however long it lets me, eventually implying through gameplay that I've done all I could for the day. This helps me move on to other games, while making sure that my time with Cozy Grove feels sacred and very different from experiences from other games. This seemingly counterintuitive approach has a lot of worthwhile uses, in fact. I find myself visiting my Cozy Grove either at the beginning or at the end of a long workday, serving as the perfect way to relax and center myself by checking in on my spirit pals and doing chores around the island. And unlike Animal Crossing New Horizons, each resident all have unique things to say, along with a full story for you to discover. It's because of these well-written characters that it'll be easy for you to remember who they are and what kinds of aid they offer you. The beauty of this simplicity is that they're also able to deliver stories through their quests that are separate from their own personal narratives. I've already mentioned how the island's chef needs a dozen eggs to just make one boiled egg, but there's also things like the postmaster's obsession with collecting weird packages that give you a sense of their quirky nature. All in all, I love all the spirit pals I've met so far in Cozy Grove, and I'm looking forward to meeting many more as the time comes. That's the rub there. Spryfox estimates that you'll be spending upwards of about 40 hours to unlock and experience all of your spirit pal stories, spread across more than a month of gameplay. And as we get further and further away from its original release date, Cozy Grove continues to be updated with additional quality of life features, balance tweaks, and performance enhancements. Even beyond its launch window, the developers pledge to deliver regular updates every 3 months, expanding the game beyond what it is now. This is perhaps the reason why I was reluctant in reviewing the game in the first place, as the game keeps changing so much. But one thing is certain. Whether you watch this review a few weeks after its release, or even years later, the heart of Cozy Grove will remain the same. It's a fun little island to visit, with residents that'll make you smile and laugh at their absurdity, who just might remind you of folks you met at some point in your life. Perhaps there's even a beautiful metaphor here about making the best use of our limited time in this world that we can apply in our daily lives. Whether you're seeking some form of enlightenment or just a great chill game to play, there's not a better game out there that fulfills these needs than Cozy Grove.